In this unit, we'll talk about the use of English by another group of Africans, but not the ones who live in the African continent, but those who live in the USA, that is African American Vernacular English. African American Vernacular English is associated with the Americans of African descent. However, it is not a variety which is used by all the African Americans living in the USA. Just as the African Americans are the most prominent minority of people living in America, African American Vernacular English is the most prominent variety of English used in the USA. A lot of research work, both in linguistics and sociolinguistics, is devoted to the study of this language and also to the speakers of this language or this variety of English. Let's take a look at brief history of African Americans. Between 1500 and 1860, at least 12 million Africans were brought to America. These Africans were either captured or kidnapped during different African wars and raids and were forcibly brought to America. They were actually a part of the slave trade which was going on between Europe, Africa, and America. Ships laden with goods from Europe would sail to African ports, and these goods were exchanged for these slaves who had already been kidnapped or were then kidnapped or captured. From these African ports, the ships would sail to America with these slaves, and these slaves were then sold for different other products, for example tobacco, rice, and cotton. These slaves were then sent to different parts of the Americas. Some stayed in the USA, others were sent to South America, and yet others were sent to different Caribbean countries. So these people were forcibly brought to America. The earliest slaves worked on rice and tobacco plantations. And because these two were considered cash crops, they were most wanted kind of crops, and therefore they brought the farmers or the owners of these plantations a lot of money. With the invention of cotton gin, which made it easier to separate cotton and seeds, the need for the slaves increased because a large number of people started plantation where cotton was cultivated, and this led to an increase in the demand for the slaves. We can have a very good idea of this increased demand from these figures. In 1790, approximately 650,000 slaves worked in the rice and tobacco fields, whereas by 1850, the number had increased to 3.2 million, where 1.8 slaves worked in the cotton fields. So, with the increase in the cultivation of cotton, the need for slaves also increased, and subsequently a large number of slaves were brought to the USA. There are different theories of the origin of African American Vernacular English. One of these theories is called substratist hypothesis. According to this hypothesis, this variety of English evolved from an unusual, forced and multilingual contact situation. And we can easily understand that it was a forced and unusual multilingual contact situation where people from different parts of Africa who had different first languages were made to work together and work together for a master who spoke yet another language. So this was a very unusual and forced contact situation where people were forcibly brought to work together and live together. It is also said, according to this hypothesis, that this language is a derivative of Western African languages, which is also quite believable because many of these slaves came from different Western African countries. And it is also said that the color of the substrate language is more prominent and is only superficially similar to English, according to this substratist hypothesis, that the original languages, the substrate languages, are more prominent in this variety. Then we have a Creolist hypothesis. According to this hypothesis, the African American vernacular English is a result of the use of English by the slaves who already used a Creole, and they used this Creole perhaps from Africa. They had already learned this Creole from Africa. Or maybe some of these slaves had immigrated from Caribbean to the USA, or the ancestors had immigrated from the Caribbean countries to the USA, and they had already developed a Creole when they lived in Caribbean countries. And so they brought this Creole with them to America. We have yet another theory of the origin of African American vernacular, which is the Anglicist hypothesis. According to this hypothesis, the African American vernacular is a result of the usual adaptive processes which take place when speakers of one language try to speak another language. So it is a result of this adaptation of the users of one language to the use of another language. One evidence for this hypothesis is that the characteristic patterns that we observe in African American vernacular, they are similar to other varieties of English. So we have different theories of region of African American vernacular, but whatever the theory is, the fact remains unchanged that the African American vernacular is a result of this unusual contact situation between speakers of different African languages and speakers of English in the USA.